My project is on biofilm in a Pet's water bowl. So what is a biofilm? It is a bacteria, a bacterial film that is thin and slimy, and it adheres to a surface, and basically the bacteria stick together and they embed themselves in an extracellular polymetric matrix, which is basically made from the microorganism's secretions that allows them to form a unit of a slimy layer. It serves as a defense system against host mechanisms to reduce bacterial buildup. Microbes form on a biofilm in response to factors like cellular recognition, site availability, and nutrient availability. They come in various colors: green, yellow, red, pink, purple, orange, brown, black, or even colorless. Biofilms can grow, disperse, or become dormant depending on the environment. So here's the process of how a biofilm forms. So basically, it attaches to a surface and they stick together. And then the matrix will mature over time and continue to grow. And as it matures, it will disperse the microorganisms and the cycle will continue all over again. Some commonly found bacteria in a biofilm are Serratia marcinensis, commonly identified as that pink film layer that you would usually see in the water bowl, E. coli, Salmonella, Typhimurium, Candida albicans, Borrelia burgdorferi, which causes Lyme disease, Clostridium difficile, human GI infection cause, and Listeria monocytogene, and there's obviously very many more. So I wanted to show you guys the adherence of the cells and the bacterium together, and if you zoom out of that, how the larger matrix would be, and then on the surface of a water bowl, it would look like a slime layer. Okay. So environmental factors that influence biofilm growth depend on microorganisms, moisture, nutrients, surfaces, and multiple environmental things such as pH and oxygen availability. So as an example, using the water bowl, there are oral microflora within the mouth of the pet, and the soft tissues of the buccal and palatal mucosa within the mouth. And then nutrient source would be consumed food from the animal, and also surface would be the water bowl or your teeth. So this affects pets by the biofilm would contain algae, bacteria, and fungi. And this can cause the dental plaque, which you can see in this picture right here, that can form calculus formation and periodontal disease and your dental caries. Also inflammation, as you can see with this red area, causing cardiovascular disease, urinary tract infections, and kidney disease in cats mostly. So how to properly clean your bowl? Wash with hot soapy water, or you could use your dishwasher but on high heat, and recommended with a rack away from other dishes. Don't add bleach in the soapy water because this could form chloramines and that could produce irritants and toxic things. And it could be mistaken as the bleach smell, but it's actually just the toxin. So after washing regularly, if you want to use bleach, you can place it in a sink full of water with a 2 tablespoons ratio per gallon. Some additional prevention methods could be to use a separate sponge for cleaning your pet's bowls and toys versus what you use to clean your own dishes. And also the different bowl types you could use could be clear glass, white, ceramic, and avoid plastic bowls because they tend to absorb particles including grease, saliva, and odors. And when washing coated protective bowls, don't use an abrasive sponge because you could actually scratch off that surface coating and the biofilm could grow within those crevices. And here are my sources.
And there's your sources. How did you get interested in this topic? Can you tell me that?
I like veterinary pathology and microbiology right now. And also, I'm really thorough about cleaning myself. So I noticed that when I was away from home and I came home, I take care of my dog, I brush his teeth, and I take care of all his stuff, and I noticed this slimy layer thing when I came back from winter break, and my dad was like, yeah, I'm not sure what that is.